How are you doing, everybody? Welcome back to our Ratchet and Clank Let's Play. In the last episode, we went to Planet Corn and found that they were holding Angela on their own Volkswagen headquarters after we found out they were transmitted his location without even knowing. And we are here to rescue her. I think before we launch that way, I'm going to quickly buy some ammo. Make sure we've got max ammo in all of our weapons. You know, just in case. Because we all know what happened. What's going to happen. He's going to have the massive robot. Massive robot fight incoming. Imagine if you actually stood under that, do you reckon that actually kills Ratchet? You know, as you put down. Grinding! I'm the dino. Walking down the third. Oh, that only did minor damage. We can recover the damage like this. Fire rate activated. Looks like we need some ammo. Looks like we need a little bit of ammo because tried to fire from too far back. Ooh, look at all the bolts. Plasmasons got through the best non-rhino weapon Like, how are they just surviving everything? This is where the big armor, the big armor we bought, is really helping out. Nope, it fell everywhere the other way. How I didn't lose the how the Tesla didn't get destroyed then, I don't know. I'll be honest, I'm very surprised we didn't lose a Tesla. We didn't lose this. The acid mod's actually been quite useful. They hit me twice and it knocks down my barrier. That makes no sense. We will grab the... Where's my heavy... My heavy bone, so... Like, there's some of these survivals. It's quite getting quite ridiculous. Issues, and I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get two shit for it. Maybe the heavy renter did actually manage to take some of them out. Interesting. Oh, maybe rushing that was a bad idea. Because there are lots of enemies now. Out. We can't attack no barrier because we're out of barriers. But looks like we've made it to the big robot. Hey, that's not nice trapping up. Why won't you admit that you kinda don't wanna hurt us? Like, the Havens actually damaged it. When we attended this in the non-challenge mode, I think we ended like probably like maximum of like a couple hits away from dying. Obviously, I do wish I did have. And he's about to destroy it. Yeah, but you started this, you right at the start, you took Clank, so you started this. No, it's V5O-Fum. I smell the blood of an Englishman. V5O-Fix, I've just had my weed to fix. such a really funny advert. That I'm a giant, but the Weetabix, they scare me. So I always felt the more of these, the yellow, like, orbs that he fires at you, I always felt they should, do some damage to him the more you destroy. Like, not, like, significant damage, but, like, just, like, fractions. And I'm not saying much, I'm trying to focus on not being hit. Ow. Okay, so it does five effective quarters. Exactly, like, admit, I don't know how, if they'd have done it like as a flat 1v1 without him having a robot, how they'd have worked that to make it like effectively a boss fight. But he's always had some sort of something weaponized, because you've got on the thingy planet, where we use the glider, when we gain Big Clank, he's in an equally big robot suit there. Admittedly, this robot suit is probably about, I think a funner way to do this could have been make Clank even bigger. But yeah. Why don't you stay still? That way, that way. jump into this one. I think I'm gonna let a couple of them hit me. Because we've got plenty of health. I just want to try and do as much damage as possible. Okay, there's two jump pads here. We're gonna take this one. We'll probably apply the same strategy. Try to just chip away as much damage as possible. Obviously, if I'm turning to try and hit him again, I'll take him out. Because I think, because we've got the best armor, it absorbs 90% of all damage, and that's from every possible weapon. Okay, we're quite close. There we go. So yeah, because obviously it absorbs 90% damage, which means that all damage is reduced.
You okay, Clank? Great.
I definitely didn't use the rifle.
Aren't you forgetting someone?
Oops.
Yeah, well, unless you're behind glass, you could definitely step sideways through the thing.
Now, before you run off, take a look at this. I picked it out of Lizard Boy's pocket.
How?
Log entry 4792, returning from Megacorp's distribution center, and beginning to suspect that Megacorp has lied to me. The extra-large decorative paperweights being stored there might actually be an enormous supply of protopets, which might explain that the whole facility is guarded by ravenous mutant creatures. Their warehouse ship...
They lied, they lied to you because you're the hired help. Yeah? The definition of what they want you to do is just be there and be menacing. And to stop any possible... intrusion on their business. That's all they want. But yeah, that would cost where we end the episode. So thank you for watching. Please remember to like, subscribe, and until next time, see ya.